वेलकम टू टुडेज क्लास एवरीवन। आई होप या हाय सो आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू हैव इंस्टॉल्ड पाइथन ऑलरेडी एंड विजुअल स्टूडियो कोड एज वेल। ओके सो एनी ऑफ यू हैविंग इशू इन इंस्टॉलिंग पाइथन एंड विजुअल स्टूडियो कोड? Yeah, hello. Okay, yeah, hi Deepak. Yes, yes. Okay, so means after running command Python, are you able to run the command like print hello world, this command? Okay, so is it working? Then it is fine. Or I think it may be a warning message, so you can WhatsApp me or means I will reply. Okay, I think you are added in the group. Okay, so yeah, so you can stay in the meeting after the class and I will see you. Okay, thank you. Okay, so welcome to day 2 lecture. Okay, so everyone, today we will be covering following topics. So first is Python program execution, second is comments in Python, third is print function, and fourth, variables and data types. Okay, so first is Python program execution. So before learning any programming language, it's good you need to understand how the program execution works. Okay, so in case of Python, you will have firstly a source file. Okay, next, after running this source code, you will get some result. Okay, this is a very basic step that occurs when you run a program. You will have a source code. Okay, any source file, if the file is of type Python, then the name of the file will be having the name of file, then it will have the extension .py. okay, so when you run a .py file, that is basically a Python file, then you will get a result. So what is happening behind this? So firstly, your source code gets converted to, it's get compiled. Okay, and it's after compilation, it gets converted to .pyc file. Means .py file gets converted to .pyc. Okay, so this is done by compiler. Okay, so compiler basically converts your source code into the compiled code. Okay, so next step is someone should run this code. Okay, so compiler compile your code. Maybe means what basically compiler does, it adds extra functionality in your code. Okay, so suppose that if you have imported any library, then compiler will automatically insert the functionality of library. So this task is done by compiler. Next, your compiled code will be converted to, so this compiled code is also called as, this compiled code is also called as bytecode in Python. Okay, in C programming language it is called as compiled code, but in Python it is called as bytecode. Okay, now this bytecode is basically read by Python virtual machine. Okay, so this Python virtual machine is an interpreter. It reads your bytecode one by one, line by line, and then it gets and you will get the result. Okay, so this Python virtual machine is basically called as Python interpreter. Okay, so the step is very simple. Firstly, your source code gets compiled to bytecode, and this bytecode is then read by Python virtual machine, that is called as Python interpreter, and then you get result. Okay, so these are very simple steps that is basically occur in Python program execution process. Okay, next is comments. Okay, so why we are firstly introducing you comments. Okay, so basically comments are very means very big role in programming. Okay, in the very beginning you will not realize the role of comment, but they are very useful. Okay, so what are comments? Comments are basically those line of code that will be not executed. Okay, you just type those lines for just information, for extra information. Okay, next, there are two types of comments in Python. So first is single line comment. So the syntax of single line comment is, it will start from has. Okay, so the syntax is has, and then whatever the comment you want to write. So if you talk about the example, then suppose that if you write has this program was created on 27/9/2020.
Recording has stopped.
So don't try to record. Okay, I am already recording the class and I will provide you video. Okay, so next, so this is an example of single line comment that will start from has, then Python will automatically understand, yeah, this is a comment. Next, we have multi-line comment. So multi-line comment, you will always write inside triple quote. Okay, so the syntax is very simple. You will write triple quote and then comment. So suppose that you want to write this comment. Okay, so here we have three lines. This is a comment written in more than just one line. So these whole three lines will be treated as comment. Okay, next, after that you are writing a print hello world. So this line will be executed, but these lines will be not executed. So I hope all of you understand single line and multi line comments in Python. So I am just giving you the example of it. Okay, so I'm creating a file here, comments example. Okay, so now suppose that firstly I'm writing here print welcome to read my course. Okay, now if you run this program, then it will print you welcome to read my course. Okay, so it is printing you welcome to read my course. Now suppose that you want to insert a single line comment. So we are creating a comment here, this program was written '23 to 2021. Okay, now you will see that this line will be not executed. So it is, you are getting welcome to read my course. Similarly, if you want to add a triple line comment, then you can use. Okay, so you will write a multi-line comment inside a triple quote. Okay, so suppose that here we are writing here this program. This program was written in 23/2/2021. Then we are writing, author of this program is Anand Kumar. Okay, and source is read my course. Okay, now if you run this program, you will get the output only welcome to read my course. So this is single line comment and this is multi line comment. These comments will be ignored by the compiler. Okay, is this clear, everyone? So there is no any limitation about adding comment. You can add, even you can add comment here also. Okay, and you can add comment like here also. So in every case, you will get the output "Welcome to Read My Course." So you want to ask any question? Now you could ask me, what is the, when should we use single line comment and when should we use multi line comment? Okay, so the answer is very simple. You should use single line comment whenever you want some immediate information about the line. Like suppose that you have a program that has 20 lines of code, okay, and at line number 14 or 16 you want that I want some comment, okay. So at line number 16 you want some comment, then you should use their single line comment. But if you are creating any function, any class, okay, or if you want to comment the whole file, then you should use multi-line comment there, okay. So basically multi-line comments you will use if you want to add lots of details about, means you have lots of details to comment, okay. So then you will use multi-line comments, and single line comment when you want to immediate comment, that should be a very simple or short comment, okay. So these are the use of single and multi-line comments. Next is why comments are important. So first is to increase readability. So suppose that you are creating any, you are importing any library or any functionality that cannot, suppose that, means first is to increase readability. It means that suppose that you have created a program, okay, after 1 year, if you see the same program, if you not comment in the program, then it will be very, very difficult to understand the program, okay. So if there is any calculation that is you are doing that cannot be understood by any other programmer, okay, or suppose that any from any other team member it cannot be understood, then you should use comment there, okay. And next is to add programmer signature. Suppose that in any simple program, like if a program is very simple, then there is no any meaning of programmer signature. But if your program is suppose that in you are working in a project and 5 or 6 people are working, then you can add a comment that this part of the program has been created by me and this part of program has been created by other people. So you can also use comments for add programmer signature, okay. Next is print function. So very basic. So what is function? Before introducing you print function, so you should understand a very basic about what is function, okay. So function is basically a usable part of program, okay. So means understand, like you have created a functionality, okay, that is basically called as function, that will be used for some particular purpose. So print is also a function and it will be used for a particular purpose. So we will see how can we create function in later classes, but just understand that print is a function. And what is function? Function is just a particular entity or functionality that we create in the program. They are reusable part of program, okay. So next is, whenever you have function in Python, then if you want to call the function, means calling of function is what? You want to use that function. So whenever you want to use any function in Python, the very simple syntax is, you first need to write the name of the function and then you need to add a parenthesis, okay. So inside that parenthesis you need to pass some parameters, okay. So this is just about function, okay. What are functions? So just don't go deep into it, okay. Now we are moving to the print function. So print is a function, I told you. So what print does, basically it prints something on the screen and also it prints something in the file, okay. So suppose that if you have some output, okay, and that output you want to print on the screen, then you will use print function. Okay. Next, suppose that you don't want to print output in the screen, you want to write that output in the file, then you will use there, then you will use you can use print there also. Means if you want to print something in the file, then you can use print. So print has basically two roles: printing on the screen and writing to the file. So print is a very basic function and it will be used in lots of part of program. So what is the syntax of the print? So it has very simple syntax. So print function is used to display result on the screen, and it is very important for debugging of program. Suppose that you have a big program and you want to print the intermediate result, then you can use the print function. When next is, we can use it for intermediate. Yeah, so I have already explained this. So the syntax is very simple. You will write print and whatever you want to print. Okay, next. So before going to that, I'm just giving you the example of print function. So syntax is what? You will write print, and then inside it you will write some message. Okay, so this is the syntax of the print function. Now suppose that you want to print hello, my name is Anand. Okay, now it will print hello, my name is Anand. Now it is printing you hello, my name is Anand. Okay, suppose that you have some so before going to that, I just want to some formatting. Okay, so just there are some options here, like end is equal to this, and then this you can also, yeah, so just I'm giving you that. So this, so yeah, so print is basically there are lots of different variation of print. Okay, so here you can also pass arguments like end is equal to this, and then if you want to print two statement by using a single print function, then you can also use, suppose that you have two statement, statement 1 and statement 2, then you can write like this, print and then statement 1 and statement 2. So the both statement will be printed. Next, I'm giving you the example of this. Suppose that you are writing print and statement 1, okay, and then you are writing statement 2. So what should be the output? Firstly, it will print hello, my name is Anand, and then it will print statement 1 and statement 2. Now you can see that after statement 1 you have a space. Okay, so this is the default space that will be added by Python when you have two or more comments. Like suppose that I am adding here statement 3. What will be the output now? It will print statement 1, statement 2, and then after it will print statement 3. So in every case we have a space here. So that is a default space that will be added by Python. Now suppose that if you want to change the space, you want to change this space by some other character like has, then you can write here sep is equal to has. So I'm giving you the both example so you can differentiate what is the difference between them. Now you can see that in the first case it is printing statement 1, and after this we have a space, but this space is not replaced by, so by writing sep is equal to this, just give me 1 minute. Thank you. Yeah, okay. So do you want to ask any question related to this? No, we are doing nothing here. We are just, if you write more than one statement in print function, then it will be printed, and default spacer will be what? Default spacer will be a simple space. But if you want to change that separation, that separator by any other character, then you can pass here. So like, not only has, you can use any character. Like suppose that I am using this. Now if you see the output, it is printing statement 1 and then statement 2 and then statement 3. Okay, next I am adding one more example. So this is what, this is application of, or you can just write here passing save parameter. Now you have one more parameter that is called as end. Okay, passing end parameter. So what is the application of this end parameter? Okay, now suppose that if you are writing here end is equal to this. Now you can see that after this statement we have double dollar sign. Okay, so it will end is equal to whatever the whatever you will pass here, then it will be just added at the end of the comment, at the end of the statement. Okay, so next suppose that you are writing here print, yeah, this is first message. Okay, then we are writing here print, and then this is last message. Okay, so next I am commenting this over. Now we have only this. So we are writing here print statement and end is equal to this, and then we are writing print, this is first statement, and we are writing this is last statement. Now you can see that output. What is the output here? Statement and then double dollar sign. And then you have, this is first message, and after that you have a new line, and then it is printing, this is the last message. So how this program is working? So if you don't write this, if you don't write this, you will get what? This is first message and this is last message. So after the print function ends, okay, whenever the print function gives you output, it adds a new line after it. Now you can see that it is adding a new line. If you want to change that default behavior, then you can just write here end is equal to this. Okay, so suppose that if you write this here, next after this message, this is first message, so it is adding a new line, but next we have statement. Okay, but default should be what? There should be a new line here. After statement there should be a new line, but it is not adding a new line, it is just adding double dollar sign, and then it is adding this is last message. Okay, so this is the use of end is equal to whatever you want to pass here. So we have discussed two parameters. So first was set and second is end. So set parameter is nothing but it is used to add separator if you have multiple statement in a single print function. So the default space will be replaced by the separator that you will pass. Next, end is used to change the default new line character by the by the character that you will pass in the end argument. Okay, is this clear, everyone? Or do you have any doubt? Okay. So next we are moving to the new topic, that is variables in Python. So what are variables? Variables are basically a container. Okay, variables are what? Variables are a container that basically stores some value. Okay, so suppose that if you have some value in your program and you want to store that value in any variable, then you can means then if you want to store that value, you don't want to you don't want that my value should be lost, so you use variables there. Okay, so variables are container for storing data values. So this is the this is just the example of how variables are stored. So you have firstly a variable name, like suppose that you have age is equal to 21. Okay, so you will have variable name, and then there will be value of variable. So this is the name of variable, this is the value, and it will be stored in the RAM. Okay, so next is, if you talk about C programming language, then the variable is basically declared first. Now here you can see that we are writing, if we use C programming language, we will write int is equal to 21. So before using any variable, we need to first type declare that variable in the old programming language like C and Java. But in Python, we don't need to write like that. You just assign the value of the variable and it will be created. You don't need to declare the type of variable. So what is the type of variable? Basically, type of variable is what type of data it is storing. Like is it storing any text or it is storing any number? So this is the type of variable. Okay, so type declaration is not needed in Python, but it is needed in C and Java. Okay, next is, a variable is created the moment you first assign a value to it. This is about Python. So a variable is created the moment you first assign a value to it. So what is the meaning of this? So I'm giving you, so variable is just very simple. So if you talk about C, then you will write int is equal to 21. So it is done in C, but in Python you don't need to do this. You will just write age is equal to 21. Okay, so this is, now if you want to print the value of age, you will just write print and then the variable name. So it will print you 21. Okay, similarly, if you have name is equal to Anu, and you are printing here print name, then you will get what? You will get 21 and then Anu. Okay, so variables are nothing but a container of data. Okay, so it stores the data. Next is, there are rules of variable declaration in Python. So what is variable declaration? So when we creating here a variable, so age is what? Age is a variable and 21 is its value. So we are name of this variable. So the name of this variable is age. So there are some rules. How can you give the name of a variable? So there are some rules. So we are going to discuss those rules. Okay. Okay, so if someone is facing issue in audio or video, you can just reconnect. Okay, so the issue will be resolved. Okay, so now we are going to discuss the rules of variable declaration. So the first thing that is not a rule. It just says that variable can have a short name like x, y, but you should not use x and y, because if some another people, if any different programmer reads your program, then he will get confused what is x and what is y. So you should use a descriptive name like is, name, total volume. So these are what? These are descriptive name. So whenever you create a variable, then the name of variable, try to give the name of variable that should be descriptive. That should give the meaningful description about that variable. So this is not a rule. This is just the suggestion. Okay. That I'm giving you. Next is rules of variables, rules of variable declaration. So first rule is a variable name must start with a letter or underscore character. So it means what? Whenever you create a variable, the variable name must start with a letter or the underscore character. So what are letters? Like A to Z or underscore character. Okay, so correct will be what? Age, underscore name, age in 2020. So these all are correct. But incorrect is what? 2020 age, you cannot write. So the first character of the variable name cannot be a number. So that's why it is incorrect. Next is a variable name cannot start with a number. So I have already given you the example of this. Next is a variable name can only contain alphanumeric characters. Alphanumeric characters are what? A to capital A to capital Z and small a to small Z and 0 to 9 and underscore. So variable name can only contains alphanumeric characters. Is capital A to capital Z, small a to small Z and 0 to 9 and underscore. It cannot contain any special character like dollar, star, has. You cannot use that in the name of variable. So if you will write as and dollar, then it is incorrect. A variable names are case sensitive. What is meaning of this? If you will write as small in this, here we are writing small age and then we are writing capital age and then we are writing capital A, capital G and capital. So these three are different. So variable names are what? Case sensitive. Okay. Yeah, so I think are you facing issue in audio? Okay, so if someone is facing issue in the audio, then you just can reconnect. Okay, then it will be resolved. So I have discussed four rules of variable declaration. So just giving you the example of all of these. The first rule states that rule one tells us that variable name should start with alphanumeric character. Sorry, variable name must start with letter. Okay, like I'm writing here. Okay. It is telling you what? A variable name must start with alphabetic character or underscore. So you can write like age is equal to 21, or you can write like age is equal to underscore age is equal to 21. So these are allowed. So these are what? These are correct. Correct. And this is also correct. But if you write here, 1 age is equal to 21. So it is incorrect. So it is violating the principle that variable name must start with alphabetic character or underscore. Okay. So this is rule one. It is what? Incorrect. So the reason is what? It violates. Yeah, simply you can write what's your name? Hello? Okay, so if someone is facing, okay, just I'm writing here. So we are writing, so this 1 is equal to 21 is correct, is incorrect. Why? Because variable name cannot start with digit. Okay, if you run this program, so it will give you error. Now here it is saying that incorrect syntax. Okay, so this is not allowed, so I am commenting this. Next is rule number 2. Rule number 2 states that variable name can only contains alpha numeric characters or underscore. It cannot contains what? Its special characters. So suppose that if you write here a is equal to 21, so this is correct. If you write here h 1 is equal to 21, this is also correct. If you write here a is, then $ is equal to 2. Or suppose that you are writing here ag $ is equal to 2. So this is incorrect. Why? Because variable name cannot contain the special character. Only special character allowed is underscore. So you can use underscore, but you cannot use another special character. So if you run this program, it will give you error. It is telling you what? Incorrect syntax or invalid syntax. So next is rule number 3. Rule 3 tells that variables name are case sensitive. So case sensitive, it means that if you write a is equal to 21 and if you write here a is equal to 23, so these two variables are different. If you print a, you will get 21. If you print capital A, then you will get 23. Now you can see that you are getting 21 and 23. Okay. So these are three rules. So this is covering all the rules of variable declaration. There is no need of rule number 4. Okay. So whenever you give a name of variable, so you should consider these three rules. So first rule is what? Variable name must start with alphabetic character or underscore. Second is what? Variable name can only contain alphanumeric character or underscore. It cannot contain special character. Third is what? Variable name are case sensitive. Now, for just I am giving you some assignment here. So suppose that if we are writing here is 2 is equal to 21. It is correct or not? Is this correct or incorrect? Okay, okay. So this is correct. But if you write here A, yeah, this is also correct. I think all of you have understood. So now suppose that if I am writing here A's and then S, S is equal to 21. Incorrect. Yeah, so it will be commented. Now is this correct or not? No, because of special characters are not allowed. Okay. So we are moving. Okay. So next we are switching to data types in Python. So there are basically two types of data. So first is what? First is primitive data types, and second is user defined data types. So there are two types of data types. What? First is primitive data types, and second, everyone please mute your mic. Okay. Okay. So there are two types of data. First data types. First is data. Data types are nothing but types of data. Like suppose that what is the meaning of data types? Means if you have text, so this will have a different data type. If you have a number, so it will have a different data type. So that's why we are learning data types. So there are two types of data. First is primitive and second is user defined data type. So primitive data types are what? First is integer. Int is basically stores, int basically stores integer values. Okay, next is float. Float basically stores decimal values. Okay, so everyone please mute your mic. So first data type is int. It is integer and it is store integer value. So what are the integer value? They are just minus infinity to plus infinity, means all will be numbers, counting numbers, and then you can just tell that minus of it. Okay, means minus 4, minus 3, 0, 1, 2, 3. These are just integer type. Next is float. Float are basically what? It is decimal type, like 1.2, 0.1. Okay, they are float. Next is in string. So string is what? It is basically text. So there is no, so I think if you have already read C programming language, so there will be a character data type, CHR. Okay, so that character data type doesn't exist in Python. So everything is string in Python. So string are what? It is so text value. Okay, next is bool. Bool does what? It stores true or false. So if you have, so it can take only two values, either it will be true or it will be false. Okay, so I think all of you are now comfortable with data types. So these all are primitive data types. So I'm just giving you the example of it. First is what? Integer. Okay. So integer. Integer is abbreviated INT. Okay. Int in Python. So now, if you write here, age is equal to 21. So this is what? This is a integer data type. Okay. If you write here, print type of age. So now you can check the type of it. It will print you int. Now here you can see that it is printing you what? Int. So this is what? This is an integer. Similarly, you can also write score is equal to 2 ended. Okay, so this is also a integer. Next is float. So it is abbreviated as what? It is abbreviated as float in Python. Next, suppose that if you are writing here, its score is equal to 31.4. And if you write here print type of score, then you will get float. It's printing you float. Next is what? String. String is abbreviated as what? STR. Okay. If you write here message is equal to, strings are nothing but text. Okay. If you are writing here welcome, or you are writing here simply like answer is equal to A. So these all are what? These all are string. If you print here type of message, then you will get here str. Next is boolean. So boolean basically does what? It stores, boolean is abbreviated as bool in Python. Okay. So it basically stores boolean values. So boolean value will be either true or false. Suppose that if you are writing here is present is equal to false. Okay. And if you type here print and then type of present. Okay, so it will return you bool. So there are four types of data that we have discussed. So first is what? Integer. It basically stores integer's value. Next is float. It basically stores decimal value. Next is string. It basically stores message. Next is boolean. It basically stores boolean value like true and false. Deepak, please mute your mic. So it is someone is getting it is maybe voice is echoing. So okay, so these are just four types of primitive data. Next we will go read these data types one by one, and we will perform some mathematical calculation using these data types. Okay, so I am just going to integer data types. So we are creating a file here, integer example .py. okay, so I told you that integers, if you want to create an integer value, you will write like this. So this age is what? An integer. Now if you have two age 1 is equal to 30 and age is equal to 2 is equal to 40, and you want to add this, you are writing here result age is equal to age 1 plus age. Okay. You are writing here print result is. So if you run this program, you will get 70. So now as you do in mathematics, like you add two integers, you can also do in Python. Okay, so addition, subtraction, multiplication and division you can do. Now in the next class, firstly we will go to one by one all the operators. Okay, and there will be some different operators that will be basically that will be only applicable in case of strings. Okay, and also the addition, also the plus operator will be different in case of a string. So we will look this into the next class. If you have any doubt in today's class, you can ask. So do you have any doubt? Yeah, yeah, please ask. Yeah, sure. So if you want to print like that, then you can just type message and then type. Okay, it will print you. Firstly, it will show you the message. Okay, it is printing welcome, and then it is printing class is str. Okay. Okay, anybody else? If you have any doubt in any part of the today's class, then you can ask. And if you go to your home today, then just try to practice. Okay, so I will also add some test related that will be related to today's class lecture. Okay, and you can just access that in the test section, and you try to submit that test. Okay, before submitting that test, you just try to practice, and I will also share this code and this PPT. Just go through it, and if you face any doubt, you can ask me. And then before coming to the today yesterday next to before coming to the tomorrow's class, try to submit the test. Okay, yeah, do you want to ask any question? Because I think because why asking any question? Yeah, I'm just giving you the where can you find the all the study materials and paste. Okay, so you will just go to your student account. Okay, and then you will log in, and from here all the study materials you can download from here. Okay, and all the tests will be available here. So you will go to submit. Yeah. No, the slide will be uploaded in the classroom, so that's why I'm explaining this. You will go to study materials and you can download the slide. Okay. Okay. Okay, so thank you everyone. Bye. Thank you.